not to identify in advance. Sometimes they are CEOs and presidents, but often they do not occupy positions of obvious power in the corporate hierarchy. They are not the flag wavers campaigning vocally for change, but rather are passionate individuals who are working to transform their organization from the bottom up.
Where the international community failed, where the, I have to say, old boys network failed, you, as young leaders, have an opportunity to come up with stuff that we need to do, with projects that we need to do, to come up with innovation, to come up with the ideas that we need for the future.
The subject is, show me the value. If you don't show the value, we can have many of these meetings, but nothing will happen.
So what are the conditions that we need to have in place, right, that help us changing the rules of the game?
Results.
Results.
You need results.
Results.
For motivation.
I think it's quite important.
Sure.
Equal leadership. We need leadership and commitment from the management in a daily decision making.
One is sustainable dividends, focusing on both the external world and internal.
More attention for green workspaces and office design.
And when we talk about creating awareness internally and creating a community, I think what we would like to achieve is to address passionate people and help them to create a professional environment to work in.
There's also an evolution in biomimicry that starts with what is possible, and then your next step is really an improvement cycle.
Our group said we need a value of money which includes people, plant and profit. So that's our new value we're working with. For example, a rainforest, should we cut it down or not? At this moment, looking to the value of money, you should do it. With the new value of money, he would say don't do it because it's not cost effective anymore.
We need to embark on a kind of behavioral-based sustainability program.
In our recruitment process, sustainability will be part. So by hiring young people, sustainability becomes a very important part of their career.
We have something in our measurement in IBM we call a personal business commitments. It's a yearly cycle. You write down your commitments and you actually get paid on it. So we agreed to put sustainability in the personal business commitments of the people for 2010.
But awareness is essentially 100% sure is now, this very moment. So instead of waiting for your grandchildren to become responsible and becoming yourself in a personal sense, which is valid for your company, taking your responsibility at this moment for your company and for your own life, that's to be done. So my last lesson is don't wait till you have grandchildren. That's not good for society, it's not good for you, life is short.
It was the shift from being less bad to being good. So focusing on being good and not being focusing on being less bad. And it was a really nice shift, and I think, like, hey, that's something that gets me motivated. Because well, positive things are things that motivate me, and I like the carrot and not the stick.
It helps, not only talking about it with your colleagues, but also seeing how other companies are working on the same subject, and where, you know, by interacting you get new ideas on a higher level, and you see also struggling of the other companies. So it also means that the fact that you're struggling is not so bad, because everybody's struggling. So it helps in keeping you enthusiastic, I think, and it also helps creating new ideas and moving forward.
If you want to make progress in your company, if you want to prepare your company for future business success, for market transition, but also if you want to get motivated, inspired, enthusiastic people in your company, then you should embark on sustainability. In fact, I would turn it around. If your company does not move towards sustainability, you are a stupid company, you will lose out. It's a change, a game change with winners and losers. Yeah.
to tell you